Hello, students. This is Plants and Animals of Southern California. And we're at Vasquez Rocks. We are at Paradise Falls. We're in Dirt Mulholland. And we're at Switzer's in the San Gabriel Mountains. And we're sitting underneath.
Hi, my name is Paul Wilson, and I teach a class called Plants and Animals of Southern California, which is a general education class. This class goes out on field trips every Friday, and we go to all different types of places. We go from the high mountains to the deserts. We then go to Vasquez Rocks, which is kind of on the edge of the desert, and then we work our way down to the Santa Monica Mountains and eventually to the coast. We'll end up at Point Doom, where we'll study the intertidal plants and animals. I go on the field trips really to renew my own spirit every week. And I think it also renews the spirit of the students every week. I could, of course, give a lecture, and that lecture would then have to be 3 hours long, and then we'd go on the field trip. But I think that the students wouldn't learn nearly as much. Instead, I have the lectures outdoors, and I just take as long as I need to for a topic. So sometimes that's 10 minutes or 15 minutes, sometimes it's 20 minutes. Now that also causes some problems because the students can't take notes very well, and so one of the things that I've done to overcome that problem is to record my lectures, and then I edit them down a little bit so they're a little bit snappier. But then in between those lectures, we're just sort of walking along, and the students are expected to be telling me about the organisms that they're passing, the ones that we've already introduced, and then we add more information. We kind of layer it. Often the students are taking pictures of the organisms, and I have them crop those pictures and adjust the lighting, and then they send them to our blog. They learn the name, and then and every time we pass it, they are asked the name again, and we start adding natural history facts and about facts about how the different organisms are related to one another. My goal is that if students come out of this class and do well, then for the rest of their life, as long as they're in Southern California, it's impossible for them to go by the natural areas that we go by all the time without recognizing organisms.